Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to No Man's Sky. I think I've found a ruin. Or not a ruin. A portal. I think. So, I think this is it. I think this is it buried into the rock. Not necessarily buried into the rock, but you know what I mean. There's a landing. It's in a weird location. I'm blaming terrain generation for this. There's actually a recall device way up there. But I think this is it. I saw it from a distance and then it dropped into the ground. But this is it. Okay, so we're gonna land here. Or land wherever it tells us to land, I suppose. I was just following the ruins, and then one off from where the ruin was. Oh, and we're in the middle of the terrain, that's great. One off from where it was, now we're parked in the middle of the rock. Okay. Hopefully we don't need to get back into the... Go away. But yeah, I found a ruin just over that way. I don't know where it is now. And then when I was about to fly away and follow the marker, I saw this. This looks like a portal to me. We're gonna go in and see if we can actually get in. It is hovering above the ground, unfortunately. So we're gonna have a heck of a time getting up there. But I think this is it. It hasn't crashed the game yet. That's a good sign. I guess we use the jetpack to get up there. I guess it was never meant to be seen from below, but here we are. So let's see if this is actually activated. I can walk right through it, no problem. There's no activation pieces for this at all. Huh. Yeah, there's no marker for me to activate this, though. Well, now they don't know where I am. Oh, and I went right through it. Go away. Get in my way. I found a portal, and then it won't actually transport me anywhere. It's like the mod doesn't even exist. I know the mod exists, though. I've verified it before I even started recording today, so... Something's weird about this. So I can get on top here. Nothing's here. There's another... These guys... Trying to get on my last nerve here. Now I need to reload my... multi-tool here. Reload my bolt caster. There we go. I'll just reload my mining beam at the same time. There we go. Sentinel drones are everywhere, aren't they? Oh, I just got up a level. Well, that's gonna be a thing. Okay, so how do I... There should be a way to turn this on. It's trouble with not reading the readme that came with the mod, right? Is that I don't know how I'm supposed to activate this thing. It being buried in the rock doesn't help either. Walking through it didn't do anything. Oh, wait, hold on. Tribute. Yeah, interact. There we go. Okay, vast portal stands before you. Hear the small, desperate voice of the Gek. First spawn. What has become of the Gek? Do they still adore the first spawn? Yeah, they're obsessed with commerce. They forget you. That's true. Portal remains closed. No. I screwed it up. Portal remains closed. They do forget you, though. They've totally forgotten you. You think they don't have forgotten you? They've totally forgotten you. Okay, fine. Remains closed. I can't do anything about that. That's just how it goes. Okay, so then I guess... I mean, I don't know if there's more than one portal per planet. It being on a moon probably made it a little easier to find, but now I know kind of sort of what they look like. Now we have to get back to our ship. That's going to be the tricky bit, because it's currently buried in a thing of rock. But it shouldn't be too hard to get to, I think. It's just terrain generation did some weird things. Maybe we can climb up to it. Maybe. There we go. Okay, so apparently it doesn't like the idea that the Gek have totally forgotten about them. But it's true. It's totally true. Okay, where's the crash ship at? Crash ship is a light year away, but that's okay. Not actually a light year. We can go suborbital and go to the crash ship. Anything's better than this current bucket of bolts we're on. And maybe the next planet will have a portal too. That'll be good. I mean, I don't know if that's true or not. How long did it take me to find this portal? Probably about half an hour. Yeah, it's been about half an hour since the last episode. Crash ship. Oh, nope. Stay suborbital. Stay suborbital. Yeah, we go about 1400. That's about right. Keep going. Yeah, so about half an hour. That's not too bad. We'll probably do an episode on it. That assumes, of course, that I didn't just stumble upon her by accident. I didn't actually verify to see if the flagpole was pointing in the right direction, but I don't think it was. I don't think it was. I think I pretty much just stumbled upon it. I'd love to find one that is not in a weird place, like that one was, though I don't think it matters. We found the activation point. The activation point's kind of in a weird place. Basically, you walk into it and point yourself up. So that's good to know. Maybe. I don't know. If this crash ship is not better than our current ship, though, am I going to take it anyway? Just to get rid of this? That's debatable. This being a hostile world where the Sentinels are going to attack us every 15 seconds, I'd prefer not. But maybe it's going to be possible. Yeah, I mean, if it's one slot above, I'm definitely going to take it. If it's equivalent, I think I'm just going to leave. Although I don't have the antimatter I used to have, huh? That is a problem. Okay, so here's a crash ship. I can't tell what kind of ship it is, but I mean, it's got to be better than what I'm currently flying, so... And those are not Iridium Arches. It'd be nice if they were, but they're not. Okay. So what do you got for me? 27? Assuming 27 slots. 26 still, huh? I mean, our current is 27. I'd prefer 28, to tell you the truth. So no. No. What do I need to make antimatter then? I need a bunch of stuff. Suspension fluid? Oh, and also destroy this thing. I mean, he's going to give me a lot of titanium, for better or for worse. He didn't apparently have a wingman, so that's just how that goes. Okay. Then we do electron vapor. Then we make... We can't make antimatter because we're missing heridium. Okay. There should be heridium pretty much everywhere. We're landed kind of in an odd spot, but I suppose it works. Where is the latest or the nearest heridium? There we go. Heridium spire right over there. Plutonium too. What the hell? Should I be making more stuff? Maybe. Looks like there's also a Gravitino ball right there, which I might as well take. Anything I can sell. I mean, yeah, it's gonna get some people mad at me, big deal. Or some creatures mad at me. You say elite. Are they really, though? Are they really? Where's the four-legged guy? There he is. Couldn't manage to get him on his... Yeah, why can't I? There we go. He went upside down and all kinds of around. Go away, go away, go away, go away. Is he actually dead? I can't tell if he's dead or not. I'm shooting him. He might be dead. Oh, no, he's not. No, he's not. He still has a health bar. It's just in the wrong place. Now maybe... Nope, still not dead. He just won't get up. So we can shoot him to our heart's content. Okay, there we go. There we go. Anybody else? Yes, but I don't know where. I mean, he's not calling for help. So I can shoot this guy all we like, but I think he's gone. Okay, we'll soon switch back to the mining beam, and then we'll take care of this heridium, and then we'll leave. Oh man, the coolant on this one is so good. Yeah, I mean, I like extreme worlds, but ones with the sentinels are going to attack us every 3 minutes is not going to be good for us. We still have a 3-star 1 level. I'm saying that like it's GTA. Like it even matters, right? We can totally handle ourselves as long as it doesn't go up. Okay. That's it for that. So now we should be able to make antimatter. We can. Can I make additional antimatter? Because that'd be helpful. There we go. Oh, I can't stack him anymore! Okay, so apparently the stack was just an artifact. Oh, that's annoying. I know I can't stack the warp cells. Okay, you know what? Then we're gonna jump two places. Okay. Go back to the ship. Can't believe I can't stack them anymore. I also can't carry any more of the... Right? I can carry one more Gravitino ball. I mean, I already have a 3-star 1 level. What the heck's the harm, right? And they're looking for me. They can't find me, though. Okay, back in the ship. Actually, pulse around to see if there's anything else cool here. There is a Gravitino ball right in there. I don't have a space for it, though. Though, I have plenty of room in my starship. Ah, shit. Okay, you know what? Leave. There we go. Up and away. And really up and away. We're gonna pulse out of here. Can't pulse yet. We can definitely burst, though. Bursting's good enough. Gets us some good clearance. And we're good to go. We have warp cells, so I don't even need to worry about it. Let's just leave this star system forever. That was a debatable beginning to an episode, right? I mean, we found the ship, but it wasn't the ship we wanted. We found a portal, basically just by following, and, you know, we're going to try to replicate that. Let's see if that works. If I can step through a portal, that'd be great. Might mean I leave a whole bunch of stuff behind, but that's okay. Oh, hey, look, a space anomaly. You know what, Paolo and Nada? I don't actually want you. What I do want is not an abandoned facility, which is what it's going to find. I found an anomaly. Yeah. Space anomaly is just Paolo and Nada. You know what? I think because the one that's right in front of me... I mean, I know this planet's nearby... And that's a moon, right? Is that a moon? No, it's a distant planet. Okay. Yeah, space anomaly there. I don't want to go to the space anomaly. They can't tell me anything that I don't already know. Let's go to this planet, because it's right in front of us. Oh, did I got too close to the space anomaly? I can burst. Yeah. I can burst and get me far enough away. Let's give it like 5 seconds, 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, no second, and then I should be able to burst. There we go. Yeah, Paolo and Nada can't give me anything right now. They can tell me where a black hole is, but that's of only debatable importance, really. I mean, I can see the black holes on the maps. If I wanted to go to one, I can go to one. It's not a big deal. But not only that, but that's not really one of my goals right now. One of my goals right now is to get a 40-slot ship. That means I'm going to gradually have to get a ship per planet. Now, that hasn't worked out thus far. We've been getting a ship every other planet. But it still kind of sort of works, maybe. I mean, technically speaking, if we do one every other planet, we should be able to find one on this world. We should also be able to upload a bunch of information. We should also be able to sell a bunch of stuff. I'm tempted to sell everything we have right now, mostly because just to free up some slots. But that's probably... I don't know, is that actually a bad way to do it? Maybe not. This world looks pretty lifeless. But no oceans, so maybe we'll be able to find a portal on here. It's possible. What we need is a trade facility. And who knows what else. Really a signal analyzer of any sort. That is not it. I said of any sort. Really, what I'm looking for is a building with... Okay, that'll work. Not quite what I was looking for, but still pretty good. I was looking for a building with a bunch of... What the hell was that? Why did I land on the surface? Oh, because there's a freaking... Okay, well, that's an unintended consequence of the mod, I think. Is making it so that I landed there instead of on one of the actual platforms. Yeah, what I'm looking for is a building with a bunch of satellite dishes all over it. That's okay. We will wait for our jetpack to recharge, and we'll zoom our way up here. And hey, look, it's Korvac's world. Hey, Korvac's dude. How you doing? Oh, right, it is, isn't it? Okay, now let me do this first, then. And sell the Gravitino balls, I can sell the pearl that I got last episode. I'm tempted to sell just everything, just to get rid of all this inventory clutter. I mean, I know I'll need it later. The thing is, that's like 20 planets away later. I don't want to do any of that now. Yeah, I'm going to do it. I'm going to sell everything. It might be a mistake. Actually, I need the aluminum for some of this stuff, don't I? Yeah, I forget what exactly I do need. I don't need all this emerald, though. I can sell the emerald. I need the iridium, but I don't need all this gold. Don't need the pearl. Don't need the ball. This is just the stuff in my suit, so that's not riven all the big stuff. I do need the zinc, don't I? Do need the zinc. I do need the carbon. Oh, right. Yeah, it's only stuff in my exosuit because I can't sell any stuff in my ship because my ship's down there, not up here. So anyway, you were going to say something to me? I'm sure. Corvax Convergence Traveler, then something else. Okay, boost the moving image inside my visor. Complex equations, okay. I mean, there's a chemical formula, directional energy diagrams, and micro-density devices danced inches before my eyes, too fast to comprehend. I could ask it to pause, but when? Okay, so chemical formula is probably gonna be recipes. The other stuff looks like it would be blueprints. We don't know all recipes yet. I'm pretty sure we know all blueprints, so we're gonna go for recipe. It says new. Is it actually new? Shit. It's a recipe we already knew. Well, all right. So it's -6 now. What is this planet like? Weather is moderate, sentinels are passive, no flora, no fauna. Okay. Well, so it goes. Alright, so let's look for... Well, let's look for a bunch of things. So we still have the gold and iridium stuff that was on our ship. We just don't have it on the... on our exosuit anymore. Not a big deal. So yeah, we're looking for... Not that, that's a plaque. We're looking for some kind of trade depot or signal beacon search thing. Anything that we could possibly use. I mean, the tendrils on this planet are not helping my cause. It's not helping me locate these things very easily. That looks like a shelter, which is fine, but not what I'm looking for. That looks like aluminum, maybe? Could be aluminum. Aluminum, yep. Okay, I'm getting better and better at recognizing these things. Nickel's the other one that looks, that's a drop pod. That looks a little darker. Alright. And I realize the anomaly is going to be on our HUD until we leave the star system. That's just how it goes. Okay, that's a monolith, which is fine, but also not what I'm looking for. I mean, I guess I could walk this world. If the weather is as good as they say, then I could definitely walk, and that would help me learn more words of the Corvax. That's tempting. I could do it. Tendril world here is starting to remind me of Quelaag's domain, but that's always true of every tendril world. Alright, just head towards the question marks as you see them. Another shelter on the left. On your left, you'll see a standard Corvax shelter. The Corvax have been known to be very friendly to passing travelers, and to not blow them up as soon as they see them. Of course, that's probably true of everyone now, because they don't have the wherewithal to actually stage any wars, because the Sentinels have totally decimated any concept of empire. So you could argue that the Sentinels have achieved their goal. They've made a totally peaceful galaxy. This looks like a ruin. That's nice to stumble upon, actually. Let's go ahead and land at the beacon here. Recall device, whatever you want to call it. And if there's a flagpole here, I will follow it. Not that it necessarily will point us to where we want to go, but it might. It's possible. Things happen. I mean, I found the other one. I mean, it might have been by accident. I'll admit that. Alright, just a giant sphere in the middle of nowhere. I'm assuming it fell down from somewhere. There is no flagpole. No flagpole probably means no portal on this planet. Which means all we want to look for then is the crash ship. There's going to be a crash ship. There's always a crash ship every planet. It's an old galaxy. It's come to the point where that's just going to happen. We're home with Corvax Prime. Yes, yes, and then you were enslaved by the Gek. Yeah, I know how that works. I've heard your story from the Viking and Gek sources. Corvax word for topic. Okay, that seems like a weird word to learn, but I suppose you know best. Alright, so yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, it's like nowadays, if you go to even, like, I don't know, the deepest jungle, you know you're no farther away than 100 miles from the nearest McDonald's. I mean, it's just true. It's true. There's nothing you can do. It is absolutely true. There's nothing you can do to stop it. There is going to be a McDonald's less than 100 miles away from you at all times. If you're on planet Earth, it's just going to happen. And so we know on this planet, we are probably no less than 1,000 U away from a crash ship at any time. What is this? It's just a shelter, right? Yeah, I think it's just a shelter. I was going to say it was a manufacturing facility, but I don't think it is. Okay, the trading post is, I think, where we landed first. I don't know why it's on our map that way, but it is. Pulse occasionally, see if we get any readings, anything else. All the tendrils are making it a little hard to see things as we pass them by, though. So I guess we'll have to wait until we get practically right on top of it. Like that right there. That's perfect, actually. Yeah, there we go. Trading post, signal analyzer. I think that'll be just what we need. There we go. Now that we're landed, I'm still tempted to sell everything, but I'm not going to do it. Let's just go ahead and I think the crash ship. Oh no, this is going to be ruins, right? I always get the two confused. Okay, so let's go inside here first. I'm pretty sure the door's over here. It must be nighttime, that's why is everything so dark. Yeah, here we go. I actually found the door, first try. Yep, this will be the crash ship. Suppose I should go ahead and charge up my exosuit's life support. There you go. Okay, let's see if we recognize this one. This should be simple. Maybe the Corvax, maybe I got used to the way the Gek do things, the Corvax do things the opposite way. Because this is just moving to the left. 6533. Yeah, that's the ruin. That is not the crashed. I guess I need the, so this doesn't have the table in front of it. That's what threw me off. That's what I thought we had before. But I guess what we need is actually the screen in front of us. Okay, I mean, the ruin's good. I'll take the ruin too, but not what I was looking for. That should give us money here, right? That's money. Not very much money, but still something. And then I think we're done. Okay. That is a door. Okay, good. Now remember, the sentinels are passive on this world, so we could just walk. Although, how long would it take us to walk to the ruin? The ruin would be 12 minutes away. That's not too bad. Let's check this place out first. This might be the signal for the... Yep, this is the one for the crash ship. Okay. Yeah, this one has the screen in front of it. That makes sense. No evidence of a rescue party. That's too bad. Transmission tower worker went to investigate long ago, but no resolution was ever recorded. Possible that the rescue party itself succumbed to the conditions and roaming predators of a strange planet. There's no predators, no fauna on this planet. Okay, I can finish the job. So this is 56 to 59. That's plus 3. 59 to 63, that's plus 4. 63 plus 68, that's plus 5. 74 is plus 6. So plus 7. would be what? 7 plus 4 is 12, so 82. That is wrong, because none of those answers are 82. So let's actually do the calculator, because I'm bad at math, apparently. Let's actually make sure that's right. Is that 68? Yes, 56 to 59 is plus 3. 59 to 63 is plus 4. 63 to 68 is plus 5. 68 to 74 is plus 6. So it's 74 plus 7. Pretty sure. It's 81. Yep, there we go. Okay. So I had the idea right. I just can't do math in my head, apparently, and I should stop trusting that ever. That's good to know. It's good to know now in the context of a game in a nice, safe environment, as opposed to, you know, when it really matters inside, you know, my bank account, which would be really, really bad. Wait a minute, I thought I had $4 million. No, sir, you forgot to carry the three. You actually only have $10. Wouldn't that be... What? How does even carrying the three help me there? I'm confused. All right, we didn't save here. That's good to know. Oh, doesn't that look cool? Look at that. Look at that rock formation. It looks like, I don't know, a rock monster or something, a gremlin holding up like a piece of ceiling or something. That's really cool. There's a natural rock formation. I didn't do anything to that. That's really cool. Okay, anyway. So, we're going to go for the crash ship first, or... Okay, the crash ship looks like 6 hours away by walking. All right, so the ruin's definitely closer. Let's go for the ruin. And if the ruin has a flag... I mean, it's possible that there's one ruin without a flag and the rest of the ruins have flags. I've seen that before. If that's what happens, then we will follow the flag. If that isn't what happens, then we won't. I can't tell. I'm so used to the way the Gek worked, I don't know if this is a manufacturing facility or not. I guess we can go in closer and see if there's a locked door. If there's a locked door, then we know it's a manufacturing facility. But yeah, they look totally different now because we're on a Corvax world. That is not a door. Where is the door? The door is, and I just bonked into the manufacturing facility if that's what it is. Don't mind me, just your clumsy neighbor bashing into your house with my vehicle. Where is the door? Is there a door? There has to be a door. There's always a door. Where's the door then? That's a good question. We should see a ramp, and I know we need to be going to the ruin, but I'm bad at this. There we go, there's the door. Okay, so is that actually a sealed door? We should be able to tell from here. I don't think it is. I think that's an open door. Okay, so it's not a manufacturing facility, so it's not of any interest to me. That's another analyzer. And we're just going to head straight for the ruin. We know where the ruin is, so I guess we can vary a little bit if we wanted to, but I don't think that matters. Okay, do you see any flags? I do see a flag, actually. It's pointing in kind of a weird direction. Huh. Alright, is there a parking structure? Oh, wait. We've already been here. This is the ruin it sent us to? We've already been here. And there was a flag, and I just missed it. Yeah, there's a flag right here. It is pointing kind of in a weird direction. We've already been here. Alright, so we follow the flag to its location. It's kind of... I mean, how are we going to organize this? So it's this way. Okay. I mean, our crash ship's over that way, so that's a problem, but we'll deal with that later. Alright, so we want to go that general direction towards whatever this tendril is, I guess. Alright, we're going to have to loop around and see if we can follow it that way. I mean, I do want to get rid of this ship, because the ship is junk. I think I've said that before. But I want to say it again, just to reiterate how much junk this ship actually is. At least in a fight. I mean, it travels through space reasonably well, you know, doesn't let it suffocate. Does its job as a ship, I suppose. Alright, so here we go. We want to follow basically along this way, I guess. More or less. So pretty much Straight to the trading post? Okay, I mean, I'll believe you. I think we're going to be a little bit off, but I don't think we'll be too far off. I think, like, just right there. I think we're good. Don't want to adjust too much, because it wasn't just general direction. Just keep your eye out. You know, that's a drop pod. We have a bunch of facilities over there. I mean, if we circle around the planet, I'd be really surprised. If we at least find another ruin on our way, I think that'll work out, because then the ruin will also point out somewhere to go. 123 should be good enough. I'm just keeping my eye around, looking down, looking around. Don't want to be too high, don't want to be too low. Though the tendrils are kind of evening out the landscape a little bit. Okay, so yeah, that's the trading post we landed at before. I don't know why it's on our map all of a sudden, but I guess because we stopped at it. And then we're just going to go this way for like 5 minutes or so. Now, if we don't see anything, maybe we go for another five, maybe we turn around and go to the crash ship. But we'll pulse occasionally. There is something ahead of us. Could be a ruin, could be anything. Could be a monolith, could be a plaque. It's something dull like that, though, we're not going to go very far. Okay, stop. Okay, just a beacon. Pretty sure we're going this way, so keep going. Problem is, I went down a little bit. But I need to go down a little bit in order to see it clearly. That's a plaque I saw on the right. And we know what portals look like now, because we started the episode that way. But, I mean, what if they don't always look that way? They might look different. I mean, that was kind of buried. And you can't go off of what I do to get portals because I am running a modded game. So it's possible that I will just stumble across a portal and you might never see a portal in that same circumstance, basically because random number generation. I mean, that's what it comes down to, essentially, is one, I'm running a mod that increases the chance of portals from 5% to 20%. And also, I mean, it's just random whether or not you run up against a portal. And we're also the fact that you can't actually activate a portal in the vanilla game. The mod I'm running also activates the portals and makes it so that it asks you a question, and if you answer the question correctly, then it allows you to pass. But otherwise, it stays inert, and that's why we had to leave that portal behind. Now, I don't know if we have to abandon our ship. If we do, we might be stuck on a planet for quite a number of episodes before we're able to get another ship. I don't know what'll happen, actually. And I have no idea what would happen even if we died. If we die on a planet without our ship, what happens? I would guess we'd get transported back to our ship? Usually whenever we die in system... In a system, we get transported to the space station in the system with our ship. But if you don't have a ship, do you just get transported to the space station without a ship? I mean, so that's the problem with running a modded game, right? You could run into these kind of situations where it totally destroys your progress. If that happens, we might just have to stop playing. I mean, I hate to say it, but we'd basically have to start over at that point. Because we would have totally destroyed our game at that point. I mean, it's possible. It's possible these things could happen. I just want to make sure I set expectations ahead of time that if that happens, we stop the series. Because, because that would be the end of it, really. And we'd be starting over from scratch, and I understand that basically that'd be the same thing as reaching the end game. So either way, we'd have reached the end game. That would have been a non-standard way to do it, though. All right, are we at 5 minutes yet? Not quite. We're just under five. We haven't seen any ruins yet. I've been bad about pulsing. Gotta remember to be better about that. Tendril World's actually worse than Water World, I think. Water World, at least we can say, you know, well, if we missed it, it was underwater, so it's not our fault. But this way, it's like, it would be behind a tendril somewhere, and I don't know how to account for that. I mean, flying higher, maybe? Maybe. I don't know. I don't think I'd be able to resolve it at that distance, though. And I'm slowing down occasionally just because I see some weird things, but then they turn out to be not so weird. The Korvacs have a completely different design philosophy. I didn't realize how used I was. How used to the Gek architecture I was. Korvac's architecture is so totally different that it's thrown me off. And it's not actually that different. I mean, it's just, you know, they like spheres. But their signal towers look different. So if I want to go to a signal tower, I end up accidentally going to the other one. And then I don't get the crash ship notification. I mean, fortunately, it was in a spot where both were likely, but still. Okay, you know what? I think, yeah, we've actually reached over 5 minutes now. And all I'm seeing is a bunch of large aluminum chunks. So unless this happens to be a ruin ahead of us, I think we just head toward the crash ship. That is not a ruin. Okay. Then yeah, we head for the crash ship. It's going to be a little farther away, but that's okay. It's worth doing these things sometimes just so we figure out whether or not we are doing the right thing at all times. Okay, so 40 minutes away. We're actually not going to go suborbital for this. It's not actually 40 minutes away. It's probably going to make it happen like right at the tail end of the episode. Especially if I burst there. Basically, I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything, and the best way to do that is stay on near surface. If I see another ruin, we're totally going to get distracted and go down that ruin. But yeah, just want to make sure. Just want to make sure. It's funny how it tells us to initiate landing. I guess because we keep pointing down. So, well, the only reason why we're pointing down is if he wants to land. That kind of makes sense, game. I can't fault you for that logic. You're wrong, but, I mean, you're not wrong because of any logical reason. You're just, you know, wrong. Could find another ruin. Could also find another crashed ship. That's a possibility, actually. Actually, that's not a bad idea. Is to get, like, two locations of crashed ships. Just in case the first one doesn't pass muster, the second one might. That's not a bad idea. I should definitely do that if I see another... signal analyzer facility. I don't know what else to call them. Distress beacon interceptor facility? I mean, that's not quite what it is. That's what it functions to in-game. That's not its actual real-world... Or not real-world function, but... You know, not its lore function. Function in the lore, in the world it's in. Words are hard. It's funny, we keep slowing down. I guess I could go up higher in the atmosphere, but that would definitely make the resolution of what's going on here not finishable, I guess. Okay, that's just a world within a world. That's okay. We're off path now, so I can move a little bit offside, not go in a straight line, be totally fine, because we know where we're going. We're just going to take forever to get there. I mean, this world is quite barren. Probably don't want to stick around here for very long. I grab enough Heridium to be able to get another crash ship up and running? I think so? I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure. It's another drop pod. I'm tempted by the drop pod, don't get me wrong. Being able to get something in the order of 50 slots for exosuit would basically be the equivalent of 25 slots. Hold on, that looked weird to me. Oh no, because it's just Heridium. Okay, but that looked like... It looked like a monolith to me, but it looked like a weird placement for a monolith, so I wanted to be sure. Okay, hold up. This is a shelter. Actually, it's a trade depot shelter thing, but that's okay. Either way works. Yep, I was going to check these things out, you know. Yeah, Tendril World, I didn't realize how much I hated it until now. Alright, we're going to land here and get another location for a crash ship, just in case. There we go. That's trick, almost crash, and then land. Okay, so the crash ship one is this one, right? That one's the ruin? I believe that's right. I think the opening is going to be over here. Or not. It's in fact all the way on the other side. That's okay. Yeah, there we go. This little roof thing denotes it. Is that always true? I don't know if that's always true. Hold up. This might actually not be right. This might be the... Yeah, this is the observatory. This is going to give us a ruin, isn't it? Yep, this is going to give us a ruin. Okay. Well, it's moving everything to the left again. So, 6-6... No, 6-4-3-6. Yeah, there you go. I mean, another ruin is not necessarily a bad idea, but it's not what we're after. Same with the Corvax is just steadily increasing. I don't know if we're at 100 yet for the Corvax. I think we're at 100 for the Gek. If that's the same ruin. No, it's not. Actually, that one looks like that one's in sight. It'd be hilarious if that was actually, like, a portal. What do I know about the Corvax that they can quiz me on? That's a good question. I don't know. Okay, so we want to go to the other one. We want to go to this one. That's what we want, is this design for the ship. It'll be funny if it points me to the same ship. We'll figure that out in short order when we only have one icon to go towards, but hard to tell. Okay, yeah, this is what we wanted. I suppose I didn't necessarily have to interact with the other one, but I did. So there. Okay, so 1, 3, 4, 7, 11, 18. So probably adding, like, 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 1 is 4. Oh, okay, so then we go, okay, so 1 plus 3 is 4, 3 plus 4 is 7, 4 plus 7 is 11, 7 plus 11 is 18, so it's 11 plus 18. Wouldn't be that be 29? Didn't even look at the calculator. Of course, it should be a simple math problem any, you know, third grader should be able to solve, so shouldn't be too thrilled with that. Really, it's just right over there, like right over the next ridge. That's what, 10 minutes away by walking? 2 minutes away by walking. I mean, I could do that. I'd be curious to see what happens to this ship if we leave it here. Will someone else claim it? Will it fly away on its own? Will it just stay there forever? Until, of course, we load the game again. I don't know. Okay, you know what? 2 minutes away for walking? Sure, why not? Let's do it. Let's walk over there. It's silly. Let's do it. I mean, we have no idea what that other crash ship is. I mean, if this crash ship is... Let's see, our current one's 27 slots, so this next one hopefully is 28. Or 29. I'll take even a 30 slot ship. I mean, whatever is the next year up. I'd imagine it would only go up by one. Should I grab plutonium? I suppose I don't really need it right now, but I might need it later. And I guess that shield icon, I don't know what that shield icon is actually supposed to represent. Because it doesn't represent the actual shield that I have. It's not about the hazard protection, because that's a different thing entirely. Really, the hazard protection and the shield are already indicated by something else, so I have no idea what the one next to the running icon is supposed to represent. And it only shows up some of the time. I mean, I like the HUD's trying to be unobtrusive, but it also gets a little annoying that's that unobtrusive. Okay, it looks smaller, but looks can be deceiving. Interesting design. Again, kind of an X-Wing look here. Okay, how many slots? 28. Okay, we're definitely going to take it. Let's compare and move some stuff over. Yeah, just move all this stuff over. Perfect. And that's all we need. I mean, I realize we're leaving a warp cell behind. That's my own fault because I dumped the warp cell in there. But yeah, we're good. 28 slots. It should technically... I mean, it looks like a fighter. Okay, so what can I do to repair you? I need lots of iron and a little bit more heridium. I mean, I can just upgrade photon cannon, no problem. I mean, the deflection enhancement, I'm kind of tempted by, but I think I'm just going to drop it. Oh, and there's some carrot sheets right there with that. Okay, that works out nicely. With that, yeah, I can already do the pulse engine launch sister. Not quite. Can I make? I can totally make another QRI cheat though. There we go. Launch sister complete. Now I need two more QRI cheats to do the pulse engine. Three more for that. How much iron am I carrying on me? Apparently quite a bit. Okay, then we're done. That was easy. All right, so I still need. Oh, that's right, dynamic resonator for the hyperdrive. Yep. Okay. How much iridium am I carrying on me? Didn't think it was that much. Apparently not at all. So it's all in the starship? Oh yeah, there it is. There it is. I'm carrying 265. And I need 100 there. So 300 total. I need somewhere around 550. Okay. That shouldn't be too hard. There was a thing around here somewhere. There we go. There it is. While I'm here, though, I might as well look at the Gek, or the, or sorry, the Korvax distress beacon, not Gek. Okay. Presumably operational parts of the engine. No sign of the pilot. Sure. Access to the ship's computer. That seems likely. If I search the crash site, I'm probably gonna find his body somewhere. Which will give me what? Maybe a blueprint, which I probably already have. Both of these will probably give me a blueprint, which I already have. Let's just try it anyway. I strike technological gold. Yep, Pulse Jet Sigma. If you say that's gold, I'll believe you. Okay, let's get out of here. And really, we could head off in any direction we wanted to. Want to go towards the ruin? I mean, really, we can transfer stuff to our ship from anywhere. So that's not a big deal. So if we go towards the ruin, that is theoretically only 2 minutes away anyway. We'll probably get Heridium on our way. Assuming that's not what that is. That is not what that is. Okay, we'll find Heridium on the way, so. Yeah, space anomaly detected. I know. Every time I pulse, you gotta tell me space anomaly detected. We're not going to space anomaly, dude. It's not gonna happen. Polo and Nada have nothing to offer us anymore. There's no way of the Atlas they can point us to. There's no anything. Nothing they can do for us. I mean, as a barren world, I mean, kind of pretty in its own unique way. Same way the desert is pretty. But in the same way, I'd get bored of a desert landscape pretty fast, and I could see getting bored of this pretty fast. I don't know, there's something about grassy plains that is just more aesthetically pleasing. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the fact that we used to, we evolved from apes and, wide open desert means no food, which means it can't be pleasing to you because it's going to be the death of you. It can be all very pretty, but if it's going to kill you, it probably shouldn't be pretty to you for very long. So the dullness is kind of like a survival mechanism. It's like, well, okay, yeah, it's pretty for a little while, but then it just will straight up kill you. Where is there going to be Heridium? That looks like aluminum. And we get higher, we can probably see. Well, there's a ruin. Looks neat. I was hoping that was a Heridium spire, though. It is not. We can recall the ship. We probably could actually recall the ship. I think it doesn't matter if it has fuel or not. I think it'll still come to us. Is there a flag? I don't see a flag. Could be on the other side. I mean, walking there would be nuts, but we could do it if we really wanted to. Okay, well now it'll be off our map. Korvax word for reset. There we go. There's a flag on this side. It says to go that way. I mean, I'm tempted to. Be a hell of a walk, though. Hell of a walk. We could do it, but again, it's the whole, being dull thing. Don't want to be dull. Where's. So, yeah, this is the way, obviously. It's that way. Nice. But, there should be another piece of this. It might be on that side, or maybe over there. Some part that activates. I guess we follow that bridge or that ramp. And come around over here. I would guess this activates over here. There we go. That's what I was looking for. That'll give us one more word. Eventually, possibly. In this carapace cycle that knows no end, this way will continue, so we'll continue for as long as our lights still shine. Okay. Interesting philosophical argument there. I don't know if that's going to be useful or not. Heridium. Where can I get some heridium? I mean, I guess... Okay, we got a journey milestone. Traveler of the Atlas Course. Okay, that's not actually an achievement in Steam. But it's good to know we got 60 already. Okay, exosuit. We need to recharge. I mean, this is a good direction as any, really. So sure, why not? We'll go this direction. And we probably won't go exactly straight. But at least now we... can be assured that when we pulse to see new stuff, we're going to hit all the question marks in the area, or see all the question marks in the vicinity. So we can look around and see. What I'm really puzzled by is the fact there's no knowledge stones. And there's some question on the interwebs as to the lore of these barren worlds. Some people say that they're barren because the Gek went through and bombed them all. Other people say it's because they're just naturally barren. You gotta expect some barren worlds. Others say the Viking did it. It's really interesting to see how much contention there is in the lore, even though it should be all laid out by all these lore stones. I will grab this, but where the heck's the... I didn't think the Heridium was that far between. I guess if the world's really and truly barren, it's going to take a long time to get to anything. Okay, so with pulse, I mean, it's in this general direction, supposedly, so I guess we just keep going in that direction until we see something. We did at least save the game, so that's something. You know, saving progress is good in case we die. We're probably not going to die, though. There's just enough plutonium to keep us going. What we don't have, though, is any kind of rich vein of anything, really. No, I mean, there's aluminum, which I guess is good. There's a little bit of plutonium. I guess there's caves. That's what I'm seeing under there. Obviously no life. But yeah, I mean, there's no fauna at all. I guess I should just grab the Heridium and go, huh? Probably. Probably best. Oh, okay, I went kerthunk. That's okay. Okay, that's gotta be a Heridium spear. Yeah, big Heridium spire right there. Okay, grab some plutonium to refuel my mining beam. And then we'll grab the... You know what? Let's grab some iron, too. We might need it. And it's right there, and I'm not sure when else we'd be able to get to it. But yeah, we grab some Heridium, we go to the next question mark, we call in our ship, and then we leave. And it's a brand new ship. We'll need a warp cell, though. Which means we'll need a little bit of carbon. Fortunately, there's a mushroom right here. Mining mushroom, that's what it is. There you go. That should be enough carbon to at least make one warp cell, I think. Actually, we'd probably do that now, huh? Actually, most of our minerals are going to be on the ship, so no. Actually, are they? Are they on the ship, or are they with us? I think they're with us. We do suspension fluid, electron vapor. Can't do antimatter because we're missing Heridium. Well, that's good, because we're about to get some Heridium right now. That's higher up than I really want to be, but that's okay. We can climb up this. Oh, there's two Heridium spires right here. In case you need a second... Come on, just burst through. There you go. There you go. Yeah, really, this is probably not an ideal place for a portal. And yeah, so the reason why I bring up the lore is that supposedly if the planet is as barren as this, it's not going to have a portal because the Gek would have gotten rid of it when they bombed the planet. I suppose there's an argument for that, but then it doesn't explain where the rest of the ruins come from. I mean, or why they're there. And it seems like if you're going to carpet bomb a world, why would you leave anything behind? Aside from maybe a plaque saying, we've destroyed this world, haha, there's nothing here left for you anymore. You know, salt the earth and then tell people about it. What good is carpet bombing a world if you're not going to tell anyone? I mean, I suppose the fact that the world is carpet bombed should be an indicator, but, you know, they won't necessarily know that. Also, isn't it kind of weird this planet has clouds? There's no water on this world. Why are there clouds? I guess clouds aren't necessarily going to be of water vapor. They could be of almost anything. I assume water vapor because it's somewhat of a temperate climate here, but it's not necessarily true. I mean, it could be a temperate climate, but, you know, there's no oxygen. So then what would the clouds be made of? Well, that's a good question. I suppose they could be made of carbon dioxide, or carbon monoxide for that matter. Carbon monoxide is white when you put it in cloud form. Gaseous forms, I should say. When you put it in cloud form, I have no idea. Okay, this should be enough iridium, right? Think so? I don't actually remember. No, we need like 500 iridium, so we might actually need the second spire, so I'm glad it's here. We can try to transfer the stuff over to the ship, though, and see how much we actually need. 14% on the mining beam. I think we're doing okay. Yeah, and then of course you have anecdotal evidence of, you know, well, I'm on a barren world and I see a portal right here in front of me. Like, well, okay, so then that there goes that theory, right? Okay, so we now do, we can't do, oh, there we go, antimatter. And then we can make a warp cell, which is good. And then go to the starship and see what we can do here. Can't do that yet. Right, we need a kerite sheet and make another one. Okay, so now we should be able to repair that and fuel it. And we need 3 more kerite sheets. I did a little bit of iron, but I guess I didn't do enough. Hyperdrive still broken, needs 100 iridium. Okay, so why don't we just transfer the stuff? Sorry, that's not what I meant to. Transfer the stuff from the exosuit. Okay, well, that's a lot of iridium. That's probably way more than we needed. And now we need iron. Iron's usually not that difficult to find. Yeah, okay, we go down here, we should find some iron. Bonsai! There we go. Oh yeah, tons of iron here. Oh, weapon charge depleted. That was fast. Multi-tool, mining beam, plutonium, there we go. Okay, and there should be enough in here to make a dozen kerite sheets, really. Anything extra, we can just make, okay, really? Really? You're no... I was gonna say we could make shielding plates out of. I don't know what your problem is. They're supposed to be passive. Okay. So yeah, we can make shielding plates out of, and no worries. That should be a ton of iron right there. Yeah, there we go, 336. That's way more than I need. Okay, so what do I need for this? I need 3 kerite sheets. Uno, dos, tres, there we go. Okay, so we still have enough for iridium. We just need dynamic resonator, and then we can get out of here. Right, I need plutonium, which I should have on my exosuit, right? I do. Transfer that over, and then I can charge this up. There you go. Okay, now we just need to call in our ship. There is a question mark in a... What actually happened there? I dropped through the ground. Okay, not as far as I thought. Okay, that was weird. That was weird. I don't know what happened there. Okay, but there's a question mark over there that I'm pretty sure was a facility, and if it's a facility, it's likely going to have a recall device. Especially since I got the mod that increases the likelihood of recall devices showing up. Alright, and we're almost at the top of the hour here. So we're gonna go away. We're gonna leave this planet. I'm going to, off camera, I'm going to grab a dynamic resonator. Yep, there's a recall device there. I'm going to grab a dynamic resonator and then I will meet you guys on the space station so that we can go away. And hopefully, I won't run into pirates in the interim. Thank you guys for watching. This has been No Man's Sky. I'm Peace of the Universe. You're Peace of the Universe too. I'll see you guys next time.